enough to come over and play here, and we're able to bring Beth over and not have to charge a cover for her, even though she deserves it. She's amazing. But there is a tip jar up here, so, you know, we just ask that, you know, maybe show Beth some love, and hopefully she'll keep coming back and playing here.
Thank you. All right, I think it's time for me to fulfill my obligation here. Need a little of this because I'm a little nervous. I know, you guys are the best audience to play something for that I've never played before. What key do I sing this in? That's a good question.
They'll be paradise.
I'm working on it. It is interesting when I talk to other musicians that gig a lot, they know, like, they just started out playing lots of cover songs, so their repertoire of cover songs is very vast. And I sort of, like, I went the opposite road. When I first started playing guitar, I just started writing songs, and that's just what came naturally to me. But you know, I would sometimes listen to the radio and try to pick out a song, but that wasn't my focus. And so it wasn't until later on, after I had probably put out one or two of my own records, that I really started learning other people's songs. And I know that's, like, it's totally backwards, but I just sort of, that's what happened for me, and that was my sort of path. So I'm always looking forward to reasons to learn new songs. So thank you, Stan, for giving me that mandate.
No, thank you.
Okay.
Of course, the next time you play, you'll too. Already, I'll be trying.
What's that?
Will you play it every time?
Yeah, of course. Of course I will. All right, here's another song that I didn't write while we're on that train. Thank you. Underground song. So Lou Reed wrote that. I'm trying to rack my brain, and I don't know what album is on, but let's get rid of this thing. Some of the songs off the new record, so that's what I'm gonna do. This one's called Curious and Free. Let's switch. switch gears here. Time to switch it up.
Rock and roll.
So this might be hard to believe, but when I was like maybe 17, so yeah, that checks out.
A couple years ago.
Just a few years ago. Some of my friends in school, they had started like a, I would call it a heavy band. It sort of was like maybe like melodic hardcore. Sort of not like straight up metal, but it was a little heavy. And they recruited me to play bass guitar in their band. And I was okay at bass. Bass is sort of a non-intimidating instrument, only having four strings to play. So I sort of picked that up and started playing bass, but the real trouble happened when the lead singer, who was also playing guitar, decided he just wanted to be a lead singer. He didn't want to play guitar. And so he said, "Hey Beth, I think that you should play guitar." And I was like, "I don't know how to play hardcore metal guitar." And he said, "No, it's really easy. You just move your fingers really fast." And I said, "Oh yeah, sure. I'm sure that's all it is, right?" So, I don't know. I did it for a little bit and played some shows with them. It was really fun. I was not the right guitar player for that band. But, you were. So I'm not going to play metal for you right now. Is where I'm going with this.
Thank you.
the small folks west. We're free from the wet. This new record that I put out, I really was looking at the past few years and really wanting to put something decidedly positive out into the world. So that sort of, for me, that kind of culminated in this song. It's called Carry the Weight. You don't have to worry. Thank you. audience. Is that loud enough now?
Yeah, sounds great.
It's really impressive how loud this tiny little amp can get, because right now it's probably on number 2 out of 10.
Doesn't go to 11?
What's that?
It doesn't go to 11?
Doesn't go to 11, no. That's a flaw.
Thank you.
the lyrics.
Alright, we're gonna keep it mellow here for a little bit more. How's everybody doing? You guys good? A lot of these newer songs, well, the ones off the new record, feel naked to me when I play them by myself. I'm trying to get over that. So I'm gonna try this one. This one is, what's the name of this one? It's called What You Want to Hear. Can we skip the part where we start getting? Baby, and all I've got is the A few more and then take another little break. How long is this supposed to go? When people start leaving, then I should stop. Okay.
We're scheduled at 10:30, but we
okay.
Can
cool.
As long as you want.
That's perfect.
11:30.
Well, depends on how long you're willing to keep the booze flowing. So, I know there's a few people here that were at my album release show, but I'm curious, if anybody was there, raise your hand. Okay. So, I played this song, it's on the new record, it's called Moment. And the song for me was just sort of thinking about how we got this huge unexpected blessing of time during COVID, and how it was strange that when things sort of opened back up, I was sort of mourning that time that we had, and just time to think, time to create, time to do the things that you sort of were putting off, even if it was cleaning out that closet, you know? But so this was me sort of like saying, hey, I wish that, you know, we could take this pause, like a little pause, to not lose that, you know, to, we're here now, but not lose sight of how kind of soul enriching taking a little pause can be. So the song is called Moment. Present fades into past. do. Maybe that's good. That's good. Yeah. Let's take a little break, and then I'll play a few more. Thanks again, everyone, for being here. If you haven't already, there is a tip jar up here, which I would certainly appreciate anything you are able to throw in there. And there's CDs and t-shirts and fun stuff over there at the merch table. Thank you so much. I'll have a handful more tunes in a few.